Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. First of all, a very happy new year to all of you. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of CodeBlocks and how to use CodeBlocks for C and C++ programming. So to watch the video till then, I can guarantee you after watching this video, you'll be able to run any C and C++ programming using CodeBlocks. And if you still face any issues in middle, you can always comment me on comment sessions, and also you can follow me over on Instagram. You can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'll definitely going to help you. So now to install CodeBlocks, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and to search over here, CodeBlocks download, hit enter. So that's going to show you this www.codeblocks.org as a first search result. So you have to click on this download CodeBlocks, and that's going to redirect to the official site of CodeBlocks. So this link, codeblocks.org /download link, I'm going to provide right in our description. So you can directly use that link to land over here. Once when you're here, you will get this download the binary release. So click on that. So when you click on that, it's going to show you this binary release, and it is available for Windows, Linux, and Mac OS, right? So all these different versions of Windows. So for Windows 10 also is what we are going to install. So you need to scroll down, and you will get this Microsoft Windows, right? And under that, we have all these different files. From here, I'll recommend you to download the fourth one, that is CodeBlocks 20.03 MinGW setup. Remember to download that .txt which contains MinGW setup. Alright, so if you are downloading something else, that will not have any compiler and will end it up getting errors. So download this one. So corresponding to this, the link is for sub this and SourceForge, so we'll download it from SourceForge. So download, click on this link. So that's going to redirect to SourceForge official site, and here is going to start downloading our CodeBlocks. You can see it is rightly started. So let's wait for a couple of minutes. So by the time it get download, I'll request you please to consider subscribing our channel along with Geeky Syntax channel. Here also regularly I'm posting lot of videos. So if you subscribe, that's going to really motivate me to make more this kind of videos. And also if you're interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. And you can see it is almost downloaded and it is done. So our CodeBlocks is actually downloaded. Let's click on CodeBlocks and going to ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes. So let's minimize our browser. So welcome to CodeBlocks setup. Click on next. So these are our license agreement. You must read this and click on I agree. So here if you see that it comes with MinGW compiler suit, right? So that is what I was talking about. So you need to download CodeBlocks that has a component called MinGW compiler. You need compiler that compiles your C or C++ code, and with the help of that compilation, it's going to run. Alright, so it's very important to download CodeBlocks that has a compiler. That's why, like, I can't repeat more enough. So that's what I was talking. So many of time, like, students are downloading, let's say the first one that contains only setup, do not contain any MinGW compilers, and they are asking. So I just can't trace this enough. Alright, so yeah, so click on next over here. So everything is fine. So on our C program files, you're going to create a CodeBlocks folder, and there it's going to install. Fine, click on install, and you can see our installation is rightly begun. Our desktop shortcut for CodeBlocks is also created, right? So let's wait for some time over here. So welcome back, and now you can clearly see that our CodeBlocks is rightly installed. It is just telling, do you want to run CodeBlocks now? Yes, we want to run CodeBlocks, so I'll click on yes, and our CodeBlocks is rightly started launching, and it has rightly launched. So you can see that it is telling that it has detected GNU GCC compiler. So if you get this type of prompt, then all that basically mean is your compiler along with the CodeBlocks is actually installed, right? So you can see it is detected. Click on OK. So now just simply click on next over here and click on finish. So that will launch our code blocks. So this is the interface of our code blocks. It's a very beautiful IDE. You can start working on your C and C++ programming over here. So let's create a new file. Go to file and click on hover over new and click on empty file. And yeah, let's write some code. So let's write one simple hello world code. So hash include stdio.h. We are going to write a C program. So int main, and within parentheses we are going to just simply print hello world. Alright, so if you want to do coding on C++, that also you can do. Just, you know, you need to, instead of saving it as .c, you need to save it as .cpp. I'm going to show you that. So first write a simple C program or C++ program on a new text document, and go to file and click on save as, and let's save it on our desktop. And let's save this file as hello world. Hello world. Alright. So if you are writing any C++ program, then you need to save this file as dot. You can see dot C I have written, right? Because this is C program. For C++ program, you need to save this file as dot cpp. Alright. And if you are writing any C program, you need to save it as hello world dot dot C. That's the only difference. Click on save. File is rightly saved. Click on the run button. Do you want to build it now? Yes. And you'll get the output coming on our console. Hello world. Right. So yeah, that's how you install code blocks and you write some code snippet and you start working on your C or C++ assignments. Hope my videos are helping you. If my videos are helping you, don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Script along with Geeky Syntax channel. They're going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. And also don't forget to watch my other, you know, tutorial, 1 hour tutorial, 1.5 hour, 1.5 hours tutorial on WordPress. I have created a fitness gym website. I have created a complete e-commerce store. So all these different videos you will get on our channel. So don't forget to watch, you know, all these different videos on our channel. That's going to really motivate me to make more this kind of videos. So that is basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.